They are the cabinet who rule us, and they are planning what to do with Scotland's oil. We know what they've done with it in the past. They took the profits from the oil in Margaret Thatcher's time, and they concealed from us, woefully concealed from us, that we were one of the richest countries in Europe, and allowed us to drift into unemployment and poverty. We have food banks in Scotland, and not just that, to our utter shame. 50 years after discovering oil, one quarter of Scotland's children still live in poverty. How did this come about, that we are ruled by 28 English gentlemen, each one of them a Conservative? We haven't elected a Conservative majority of Scottish MPs for nearly 50 years, yet year after year, we get a Conservative government. How did we get into this position? It happened 300 years ago when union didn't mean very much at all. Now it means everything. We are submerged in the United Kingdom. A yes vote seems such a little thing to ask, yet there are people in Scotland so used to having nothing, or making do with very little. These are the people who must vote in September to see us clear of this hellish union. The vote in September can make a difference and will make a difference. If we get the wealth of Scotland into our own hands, we become one of the richest countries in the world. We are the richest part of the United Kingdom insofar as income is concerned, and the poorest part as far as wealth distribution among our people is concerned. Our people get poorer and poorer, and the rich get richer and richer, and the rich are nearly all in the southeast corner of this island, where the 28 rulers in Aberdeen have come from. Let us never forget that the union of Jonah with the whale is equivalent to the union of Scotland with the rest of the United Kingdom.